kindergarten jitters. Written by Nicole. Narrated by Joanna Teljeur. It all started on Lewis's fourth birthday. All of his friends and family came over for Lewis's birthday party. He ate double chocolate cake, played games, sang songs, danced, and even got to open all of his presents. It was his best birthday ever. That night, Lewis got ready for bed. He brushed his teeth, put on his favorite superhero pajamas, and climbed into his new big boy bed. Mommy! I'm ready for my bedtime story, Lewis called out to his mother. His mother walked in with their dog Luther, following on her heels. Luther was a huge English Mastiff. He was almost as big as a pony. Luther jumped up on Lewis's bed and plopped down on top of his legs. Luther, move over. Giggling, he tried to free his legs from under Luther. Chuckling, his mommy pulled the blankets up, tucking him in so he was snug as a bug. Lewis, do you know what it means now that you are 4 years old? She asked him. Looking up at his mother, Lewis shook his head no. You get to go to school with other boys and girls. It's very exciting, his mother said. But mommy, I want to stay home with you. I don't want to go to school, he cried. Lewis was scared and didn't want anything to change. He wanted to stay at home with his mommy like he'd always done. It's going to be so much fun, Lewis. You will make new friends and learn lots of new and interesting things, she said. Turning the page, his mother started reading the bedtime story to him. Lewis was so worried about having to start school that he didn't hear a word she read to him. The Sunday before school, Lewis and his mother were packing his backpack for school the next day. He was still worried about going to school and didn't want to go without his mommy. Mommy, are you still coming to school with me tomorrow? Lewis asked. Of course I am, silly. I can't stay with you the whole day, but I will be with you until the bell rings, she said. But I don't want to go. I want to stay home with you. I love you, and I don't want to leave you. Mommy, why can't everything just stay the way it is? Lewis cried and hugged his mother. You are such a brave boy, Lewis. I know you can do this. It will be all right. You'll see, she said. That evening, Lewis went to bed early. He was still worried about going to school the next morning. What was he going to do without his mommy? They did everything together. She was his bestest friend ever. When Lewis was scared, his mommy was always there to make him feel better. She was there to kiss his boo-boos better when he got hurt, and she gave the very best hugs in the whole entire world. Lewis was so worried about missing his mommy that he hardly slept a wink. Lewis, time to wake up. Today is your first day of school, his mother said cheerfully. When Lewis didn't stir, his mother playfully shook his shoulder. Squeezing his eyes shut tightly, Lewis rolled over, hugged his tummy, and groaned in pain. I don't feel so well, Mommy. I can't go to school, Lewis grumbled. His mother placed her hand on his forehead to see if he was warm. Lewis was just the right temperature. Nice try, Lewis. Come on, let's get you ready for school, she said. After breakfast, Lewis and his mother walked to school together. On their way, they met Mr. Mullings, the crossing guard. His job was to make sure everyone crossed the road safely.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books,
Use the link in the video description.